ஓகே, ஸோ இப்போ நம்ம சிம்பிள் டெஃபினிஷன்ஸ் எல்லாமே வந்து பார்த்துட்டோம். கெயின் என்ன, ரிவர்ஸ் கெயின் எப்படி இருக்கும், ஓகே வாட் இஸ் ரிஃப்ளெக்ஷன் கோஎஃபிஷியன்ட் அட் தி இன்புட் போர்ட் ஆஸ் வெல் அஸ் அட் தி அவுட்புட் போர்ட், தென் வாட் இஸ் தி இன்புட் ரிட்டர்ன் லாஸ், தென் வாட் இஸ் தி அவுட்புட் ரிட்டர்ன் லாஸ், வாட் இஸ் தி அவுட்புட் ரிட்டர்ன் லாஸ், இதெல்லாம் வந்து பார்த்தோம். ஓகே, அண்ட் அகெயின் எது சொல்லியிருந்தேன், எஸ் ஒன் ஒன்னால என்னது, ரிஃப்ளெக்ஷன் கோஎஃபிஷியன்ட். ஓகே, ரிஃப்ளெக்ஷன் கோஎஃபிஷியன்ட் அட் இன்புட், ஒன்ஸ் அகெயின் ஐ வில் ரைட். ஓகே, ஸோ reflection at input, reflection at input is equal to simply 20 log of S11. Similarly, reflection at output is equal to what? 20 log of S22, 20 log of S22. Okay, this is the basic definition. Now, for any microwave device, I can write the matrix like this, B matrix and S matrix and A matrix. Okay, then B is like a reflected wave. B is like a reflected wave. A is like always incident wave. Okay, this is always with respect to two port network parameter. This reflected wave could be an incident wave for your load, that I do not worry about that. Okay, this is with respect to two port network. Okay, so B is means reflected wave, incident wave. And S means what, sir? Scattering parameter matrix. This S is called scattering matrix. This S matrix is called scattering matrix. Okay, this will define the nature of the microwave device, because you are giving some incident wave, you are giving wave, reflect wave or some load wave, that's okay, that's secondary. But this will define the scattering matrix will define the nature of the microwave device. Okay, it denotes nature of microwave device. It denotes the nature of microwave device, because அதாவது ஒன்ஸ் அந்த எஸ் பேராமீட்டர் பார்த்தே நீங்க அந்த மைக்ரோவேவ் டிவைஸ் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டிஸ் ஆஃப் ஓகே ப்ராப்பர்ட்டிஸ் ஓகே ப்ராப்பர்ட்டிஸ் ஆஃப் எஸ் ஸ்கேட்டரிங் பேராமீட்டர் இட் ஹேஸ் டு ஃபாலோ சம் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டிஸ் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி இஸ் த எஸ் மேட்ரிக்ஸ் இஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் ஸ்கொயர் மேட்ரிக்ஸ் எஸ் இஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் ஸ்கொயர் மேட்ரிக்ஸ் Okay, square matrix means what? Number of rows is equal to number of columns. Mute your mic, please. Check your mic and mute your mic, all of you. Mute your mic. Okay, next one is, this matrix is always symmetric matrix. Generally, Sij is equal to Sji. Okay, symmetric in the sense, and again, it need not to be symmetric always, but if it is symmetric, then Sij is equal to Sji. Okay, this is true if symmetric. If the microwave device is symmetric, that means what? You interchange the output port and input port, it will still behave in the same way. That is the concept of symmetriness. Okay, symmetry, then you know rows and columns can be interchanged. Okay, S12 is equal to S21. That means what? If you give input at port 1, then you will get output at port 2. Or otherwise, if you give the input at port 2, then you will get the output at port 1. Same performance it will give. That means if the microwave device is symmetric, then this is true. And the third properties is, it always follows the unitary properties. This is very important. Most probably you will get questions based on this in the exam. Okay, the microwave device has to follow the unity properties. Yes. Okay, S star is equal to simply I, identity matrix. Okay, identity matrix, unitary matrix. Okay, S star is equal to unitary matrix. Once if the situation comes, then I will explain how to use these properties. Okay, so first we'll go to the E-plane junction. Okay, now we'll go to the basic microwave device, that is E-plane T. The another name for this one is Sirius T. Another name for this one is Sirius T. Okay, now I'll draw the diagram of that one. okay, somehow I have drawn, okay. Port, this is port 1, sir. This is port 1, this is port 2, this is port 3. Is symmetric or asymmetric device? It is a symmetric device. I am going to put the same thing. So this is a symmetric device. First, I will explain you concept. Okay, later. I will explain you. Okay, now we will get 10 watt power. Sir. First, we will get 10 watt power. The power is equal to distribute. We will get 5 watt power. We will get 5 watt power. But, ஒரு எண்டில் வந்து 5 வாட் கிடைக்கும், இன்னொரு எண்டில் வந்து இது வந்து என்னது ஆப்போசிட் ஆகிட்டு கிடைக்கும். இன்னொரு எண்டில் வந்து ஆப்போசிட்னா மைனஸ் 5 வாட் கிடைக்கும். எப்படி சார் 5 -5 0 அப்படிலாம் சொல்லாதீங்க. ஓகே, திஸ் இஸ் பவர். ஓகே, மை பவர் இஸ் கெட்டிங் டிவைடட் ஓகே இன்டு டூ பார்ட்ஸ், 5 வாட் 5 வாட். பட் ஒன் இஸ் வித்தவுட் எனி ஃபேஸ் ஷிப், அனதர் ஒன் இஸ் வித் ஃபேஸ் ஷிப். ஓகே, திஸ் இஸ் த பவர். ஓகே, திஸ் இஸ் த பவர். அண்ட் டோன்ட் திங்க் தட் திஸ் இஸ் பிளஸ் அண்ட் திஸ் வில் கோயிங் டு பி மைனஸ் தென் finally this is like a zero. Don't imagine like that, because power is getting uniformly distributed, but whatever the power that you are having here, it will have the opposite phase. That's the idea, because if the electric field is going in this way, here the electric field will go in the opposite way. That is the idea. The orientation of the electric field will be somewhat different. Okay, say for example, in the first, if the electric field is here, you are giving some power here. If the electric field is here, when it comes there, the electric field becomes like this, but when it goes here, the electric field becomes like this. Once you imagine, then you can understand that. If this diagram comes here, it comes like this, okay. Then if it goes here, then that's why the power is uniformly getting distributed, but here without one, at one end without phase shift, at another end with phase shift. And again, where you are getting the phase shift, it all depends on what is the orientation of the electric field. Now the orientation of the electric field may be in this direction, or it may be in the opposite direction. So what is sure, whatever the things that you are getting, opposite things you will get here, or otherwise you may get phase shift here you may not get. That is the idea. So that means with the help of parameter, how I can mention, because I am giving power at port 3, now I am getting power at port 1. That means what? S13. Okay, S13, that means 3 means 1 denotes the output port. Okay, output port. 3 denotes the input port. I am giving power at the third port. I am getting some power at the port 1. That means S13. Please always, if I am mentioning S13 as something, first number denotes the, or otherwise, in general, say for example, if Sij means this I denotes the output. This I denotes the output. This J denotes the input. This J denotes the input. Okay, so S13. Is equal to, and again this is S23, but this is of opposite nature. Okay, see, this way it is going, the things that is going this way, this is S13 here. Once if it goes in this way, then that is actually S23, but it is of opposite nature. That's why S13 is equal to minus S23. S13 is equal to minus S23. That means what? When you feed your waves in a E-plane junction at the third arm, then you will get equal power with phase shift at the other arms. Okay, what is the statement? Wave feed in arm 3 appear in port 1 appear appear in port 1 and 2 with the same magnitude and opposite phase magnitude and opposite phase. Again, one more thing we are considering: when I am giving 10 watt power, whether is there any reflection here? Because reflection irundhadna, you cannot get 5 watt 5 watt here. Suppose நான் 10 வாட் தரேன், 2 வாட் ரிஃப்ளெக்ட் ஆயிடுச்சு, அப்போ நான் என்ன என்னதான் கிடைக்கும்? ரிமைனிங் பவர் தான் கிடைக்கும், 4 வாட் 4 வாட். ஸோ வி ஹவ் டு அனலைஸ் தட் ஆல்சோ. பட் வாட் வி ஆர் அசியூமிங், தேர் இஸ் நோ ரிஃப்ளெக்ஷன் அட் தி போர்ட் 3. தேர் இஸ் நோ ரிஃப்ளெக்ஷன் அட் தி போர்ட் 3. அகைன் ஆல் போர்ட்ஸ் ஆர் மேட்ச்டு. தேர் இஸ் நோ போர்ட் அட் தி ரிஃப்ளெக்ஷன், சாரி, போர்ட் 3, நோ ரிஃப்ளெக்ஷன் அட் போர்ட் 3. சிமிலர்லி இங்கே நீங்கள் சம் டிவைஸை கனெக்ட் பண்ணியிருப்பீங்க, அது 5 வாட் அப்சர்வ் பண்ணலன்னா ரிஃப்ளெக்ஷன் ஆகிடும். பட் வி ஆர் அசியூமிங் that is also matched. That means what we are assuming, all the ports are matched. Once if all the ports are matched, then there will not be any reflection. There will not be any reflection. See what I am telling. இப்படி இருக்கு சார், நீங்க 10 வாட் பவரை தரீங்க, 10 வாட் பவர் தந்தீங்கன்னா இங்க 5 வாட் பவர், இங்க 5 வாட் பவர். அப்போ இங்கேயும் என்ன கிடையாது, எந்த ரிஃப்ளெக்ஷன் எதுவும் கிடையாது. ஓகே, ஜஸ்ட் பவர் இஸ் கோயிங் இன் திஸ் வே, நோ பவர் இஸ் கோயிங் டு தட், நோ ரிஃப்ளெக்ஷன். அப்போ இங்கேயும் என்ன பவர் கொடுக்குறீங்களோ அது அந்த டிவைஸ் எடுத்துக்குது. ஏதோ சம் டிவைஸ் யூ ஹவ் கனெக்டட், ஓகே, நோ ரிஃப்ளெக்ஷன் ஃப்ரம் த டிவைஸ். சிமிலர்லி இயர் ஆல்சோ 5 வாட் பவர் இஸ் கம்மிங், யூ ஹவ் கனெக்டட் சம் டிவைஸ், ஓகே, தட் இஸ் டேக்கிங் த பவர் பட் தட் இஸ் நாட் ரிஃப்ளெக்டிங் த பவர். தட் மீன்ஸ் வாட், all the three ports are matched. We are assuming like a matched port. Okay, this is like assumption only. In reality it may behave with some reflection, but I am assuming here. If all ports are matched, matched means you will not get any reflection from the port. Okay, if all ports are matched, then what is the meaning? There is no reflection. S11 is equal to 0, S22 is equal to 0, S33 is equal to 0. Okay, and one more properties also I will tell you. Suppose if I am having E-plane junction like this, if I am giving 5 watt with the 0 phase and 5 watt with the 0 phase, then how much power I will get here? Imagine money, solunga sir. If I get 5 watt here, 5 watt here, evlo power inga kedaikum? Or otherwise you tell me this situation one end, because opposite la solran nan. First neenga port 3 la thanda adu distribute aachu, ipo port 1 port 2 la neenga tharinga, adu vandu enga povum? Port 3 ku povum. Ipo second case paarenga, nammalku similar ah irukku, inga inga irukku opposite ah irukku. Appo inga ungalku ethana watt kedaikum? 10 watt kedaikum. Inga ethana watt dhan kedaikum? 0 watt dhan kedaikum. Inga ethana watt dhan kedaikum? 0 watt dhan kedaikum. Ena idu rendum ஆப்போசிட் ஃபேஸில் இருந்தால் தான் இங்கே வந்து என்ன வர பவர் வர சான்ஸ் இருக்குது. ஓகே, இது ரெண்டும் சேம் ஃபேஸில் இருந்ததுன்னா இங்கே வரும்போது அது என்ன ஆகிடும்? கேன்சல் ஆகிடும். இங்கே வந்துட்டு இப்படி போ ட்ரை பண்ணும்பொழுது, அப்போர்ட்டில் போ ட்ரை பண்ணும்போது அது என்ன ஆகிடும்? கேன்சல் ஆகிடும். ஸோ இப்படின்னு கொஸ்டின் கேட்கலாம் எக்ஸாம். ஓகே, ஸோ பட் அகைன் ஆஸ் பர் த சிமெட்ரிக் கான்செப்ட் ஆல்வேஸ் S12, ஓகே, S12 இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஆல்வேஸ் S21. S12 இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஆல்வேஸ் S21. என்ன மீனிங்? வாட் இஸ் த மீனிங் ஆஃப் திஸ் ஒன்? S12 is equal to always S21. Okay, we do not know what is the nature of S12 and S21, but S12 is always is equal to S21. Similarly, because due to symmetriness, S31 is always equal to S13, S23 is always equal to S32. Okay, S32 due to symmetriness. And again, I will apply the unitary properties. Unitary properties means S dash is equal to I. S dash is equal to I. So what is the general matrix format? S is equal to S11, S12, S13, S21, S22, S23, S31, S32, S33. This is the general scattering parameter matrix, 3x3 matrix, because it is having 3 port. And again, I am making some conclusion, because S11 is always 0. This is S21. This is S13. And S21 is similar to S12, so I can write it is right S12 here, and again 0 here, and S23. S31 is similar to S13, so S13, and S32 is similar to S23, okay, S23, and again 0 here. Now I am going to apply one more condition, because here I am having this formula. Okay, S31, I think I have written here. I am going to apply this formula. S13 I can replace with minus S23. Okay, S13 is always minus S23. So, or otherwise S23 I can replace with minus S13. Okay, minus S13. So, finally I can write like this. Okay, this is 0, S12, S13. S12, S22, instead of S23, I can write minus S13, and S13, minus S13, and S33. This is the final matrix. Now, you apply the unitary properties. Okay, this is your S matrix, this is your S star matrix. Apply panna enna sir varum? Okay, this is 0, Okay, S12, S13, S12, S22, minus S13, S13, minus S13, S33, and again same thing, you put a star here. S1 star.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
S22, S33, 0. 0.
Yes. Okay, then you apply the star here. Okay, you'll get S11, S12 star, 0, minus S13 star, and S13 star, minus S13 star, and 0. That is equal to I. I means what, sir? 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, when you'll get this one value, when you take first row and first column, you'll get 1. Similarly, when you take second row, second column, you will get this one. Similarly, third row, third column, you will get this one. Remaining thing is zero. Okay, because I'm going to concentrate on unity properties. Okay, and again, once if you make remaining combination, then that is zero. Okay, now you make a combination like this. Now with this, how many equations you can form? With this matrix, actually you can form 9 equations. Because 9 number is there, you can make 9 equations, 3 by 3. Okay, 3 by 3, 9 equations you can form. Okay, and again you are having 9 equation. How many parameter is there? 9 parameter is there. How many already some parameter is 0, that's okay. Yes, sir, are you understanding this concept? Now you can make 9 equation. How many parameter is there in general? 9 parameter. Already some parameter is 0, that's okay. Then you can get the unique values. Okay, so with this 9 equation and 9 variable, so you can get the solution. Okay, adha neenga senju paarenga. When you are at free time, please try to do it. 9 equation, 9 variable, then you can find solution. You can find solution. That too unique solution, because 9 equation, 9 variable is there, that you can find out the unique solution. Okay, unique solution is possible. That solution I will write directly. That is important exam point of view. 1/2, okay, 1/√2. This I will derive for magic plane T, magic D, EHT, but for E plane and H plane, that is simple, so I will write directly. Okay, or otherwise you refer some book. Again, for exam point of view, derivation is not important. Finally, this matrix you have to remember. If at all, if they ask questions, finally they'll ask what is the scattering matrix of E plane. Very, very important. Finally, you have to remember the scattering parameter of the E plane junction. Scattering parameter of the E plane junction. Something is going wrong. S11 and all, we have taken 0 here. 1/2 is coming. Yes, sir. Finally, we have assumed it is a matched junction, but finally S33, because we have assumed S11 and everything is 0, but finally in the answer we are getting something. How that is possible? Any idea is there, or otherwise where we have made a mistake? Or even if it is not matched junction, okay, there we have assumed like a matched junction. And again, without assuming as a matched junction, enna solla varana, there we have assumed as a matched junction. Okay, if the matched junction is there, then everything is zero. If it is not a matched junction, okay, if matched junction is there, if all the ports are matched, then everything is zero. Or in reality, it may not have a matched condition. It can be anything. Okay, simply S11 and S22 and S23. Okay, so if it is really matched, then everything will go zero accordingly. You will get answer. If it is not matched, okay, if it is not matched also, you can derive, because you are having 9 equation, 9 variable. So even if it is not matched, you can find out the answer. Okay, even if the ports are not matched, okay, you can find out the answer. S33, and accordingly you will change this S11, S12. S22, S33, S11 star, S22 star, S33 star. Okay, what I'm telling, even if it is not matched, also you will get, this is the final answer for E plane. Okay, E plane T, because you are going to analyze about the characteristics of the device, because whether it is matched or not, it depends on the another device that is connected with E plane junction. அதாவது என்ன சொல்ல வரேன்னு பாருங்க, இப்படி இருக்கு சார் இ பிளேன் ஜங்ஷன். இப்போ இந்த போர்ட் மேட்ச்டா இல்லையான்றத இங்க ஏதோ ஒரு டிவைஸ் கனெக்ட் பண்ணும்போது தான் நமக்கு தெரியும். ஓகே, அதனால நம்ம வந்து இது மேட்ச்டுன்னு ஆல்வேஸ் சொல்ல முடியாது. இட் டிபெண்ட்ஸ் ஆன் வாட் டிவைஸ் யூ ஆர் கனெக்டிங் ஹியர். பட் நவ் வாட் இஸ் அனலைசிஸ் வி ஆர் டூயிங், வி டு நாட் நோ வெதர் தட் இஸ் மேட்ச்ட் ஆர் நாட், தென் வாட் இஸ் த கேரக்டரிஸ்டிக்ஸ் ஆஃப் திஸ் இ பிளேன் ஜங்ஷன், அதுதான் நம்ம வந்து அந்த ஆன்சர்ல எழுதியிருக்கோம். ஸோ வி டு நாட் நோ, அதுதான் வந்து நம்ம ஜெனரலைஸ்டு ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட்ல எழுதியிருக்கும் 1/2, 1/2. பட் இஃப் இட் இஸ் மேட்ச்ட் தென் திஸ் இஸ் ரியலி ஜீரோ, S11 இஸ் ஜீரோ, ஆர் அதர்வைஸ் தட் இஸ் 1/2. ஓகே, ஸோ ஃபைனலி யூ ஹவ் டு ரிமெம்பர் திஸ் திஸ் மேட்ரிக்ஸ் வேல்யூ ஃபார் இ பிளேன் ஜங்ஷன். ஓகே, இ பிளேன் டி. ஓகே, நெக்ஸ்ட் ஐ வில் கோ டு எச் பிளேன் டி. திஸ் மச் டீடைல் ஐ வில் நாட் கோ, ஐ வில் ரைட் டைரக்ட்லி. ஓகே, H plane D. I'll give you some basics. ஓகே, திஸ் இஸ் ஹெச் பிளேன் டி. அந்த டயக்ராம் பார்த்தீங்கனாலே தெரிஞ்சிருக்கும், ஃபஸ்ட்டு வந்து இந்த எக்ஸ்ட்ரா பீஸ் வந்து மேலே இருந்தது வெர்டிகலாக, இப்போ இங்கே ஹரிசாண்டலே இங்கே கொடுத்துருக்குறாங்க. ரெண்டுத்தையும் கம்பேர் பண்ணி பாருங்கள். அப்போ ஒரு ஒரு இ பிளேனா ஹெச் பிளேனு பார்த்த உடனே சொல்லிடலாம். ஓகே, ஃபிசிக்கல் அப்பியரன்ஸ்லேயே உங்களுக்கு தெரிஞ்சிடும். ஓகே, இந்த எக்ஸ்ட்ரா ஆர்ம், தேர்ட் ஆர்ம்ஸ் வந்து எங்கே கனெக்ட் பண்ணியிருக்காங்க, ஆல்ரெடி தெர் இஸ் எ வேவ் கைட். இஃப் த எக்ஸ்ட்ரா ஆர்ம் இஸ் கனெக்டட் அப்வர்ட் ஆன் திஸ் பிளேன், தென் தட் இஸ் இ பிளேன். இஃப் இட் இஸ் கனெக்டட் ஹியர், தென் தட் இஸ் H plane, that is H plane. Okay, path one terino safe, and this is port 1, and this is port 2, and this is port 3. Now what I'm going to do, suppose if I am having 10 watt power, how this is getting distributed? Here I will get 5 watt power, here I will get 5 watt power, but now here I will not get any phase shift between the power that is present at port 1 and port 2. Okay, I will not have any phase shift. Okay, I will not have any phase shift. 5 watt, 5 watt, that is main idea here. So what is already, again, what is the relation? Something is goes from 3 to 1 and 3 to 2, that is always equal. The relation between 3 to 1 and 3 to 2 is always equal. So S13 power at port 1 due to power input at the port 3 is equal to power at port 2 due to the power input at the port 3. So S13 is always equal to S23. S13 is always equal to S23. And once again, if you do the derivation, simple derivation with help of unitary properties and other properties, finally you will get the S matrix, something like this. I will directly write the S matrix. And one more thing also you should know. See, suppose if the junction is like this, instead of giving power at the port 2, I can give the power at this port. Say if I am giving 3 watt here, and again if 3 watt here, then definitely I will get 6 watt power here. That is also possible. Okay, that also you should know. Okay, so if you give the power here, that is getting uniformly distributed. If you give here, then that will add up and you will get the power here. Okay, that's the idea. So, and again, this H plane is acting like a power adder, and previous case that E plane may act as a power subtractor. Okay, like a difference operation it can do. It can do the addition operation, mathematical operation. Okay, so then finally, what is the matrix value? S matrix value. The S matrix value is equal to 1/2. You have to remember this exam point of view. Exam le idan sir kepanga. minus 1 by 2, 1 by root 2, minus 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. Again, in the exam, you no need to remember this value also, sir, root 2, root 2 or root 2 like that. But once if you know the properties of H plane T, see what is the properties? 3 lirundu 1 ku varradum 3 lirundu 2 ku varradum correct ah irkanum adha paathe neenga enna pannikalam naal matrix ah kuduthirukka poranga. Once if you know this simple trick, there is no phase shift trick. Once if you know the trick, then you can easily find out. Again, the matrix has to be symmetric always, that's okay, but this has to follow this condition: S13 is equal to S23. This is very very important, H plane, because once if it is H plane, then immediately this has to come to your mind. Once if this concept is clear to you, then you can just tick the answer. No need to remember this value and all. Okay, so when the wave is fed at the port 3, then it is getting uniformly distributed in port 1 and port 2 with equal amplitude and phase. Okay, what is the idea? When wave is fed at port 3, that is equally distributed, that is equally distributed in port number 1 and port number 1 comma 2 with equal amplitude and phase. Idha ungalku theriyum. Okay, next I will go to the hybrid T junction or magic T junction. Okay, I'll draw only the two dimensional diagram. Okay, this is the two dimensional diagram only. Please imagine for three dimensional. Okay, now this is arm 1 and this is arm 2, and once if it is in the same plane, this is like arm 2 and this is like arm 3, this is like arm 4. Once if it is on the same plane, then that arm is called H arm. This arm is clearly H arm. If it is on the different plane, then that is E arm. Okay, because 1, 2, 3 is on the same plane. Adhu pola structure arundha adhu vandha adhu H arm. Suppose in the plane ku perpendicular ah irukudhu. In the plane already 1, 2 is one plane, then that is perpendicular to fourth one, then that is E arm. Okay, and the diagram, three dimensional diagram paathina ungalku idea kedaikum. Okay, so this now we are discussing about what hybrid or magic T. Okay, this is called hybrid or magic T. That means what? Combination of E plane junction and H plane junction. Combination of E plane and H plane junction. Okay, E plane and H plane. Now, what is this? What is the nature properties of this one? Always the E arm, H arm is always perfectly matched. Okay, E arm and H arm is always perfectly matched. E arm and H arm always perfectly matched. Once if it is perfectly matched, there is no reflection. That means what? This implies, S33 is equal to 0, S44 is equal to 0. Okay, S33 means H arm, S44 means E arm. Okay, then port 3 and port 4 is always isolated. Okay, then the next point is port 3 and port 4 is always isolated. That means what? If you are giving some power at the port 3, then that may go to port 1 and 2, but that will not go to port 4. Similarly, if you are giving some input power at port 4, that may go to port 1 and 2, that will not go to port 3. That is the meaning of this statement. Port 3 and port 4 is always isolated. So that's why S34 is equal to 0. That means even if you give the power at port 4, you will not get any power here. S34 is equal to 0. And similarly, S43 is also is equal to 0. That means what? If you give power here, you will not get any power. That is S43 is equal to 0. And you know, this is consists of both E-plane junction and H-plane junction. Once if it is E-plane, then S14 is equal to minus S24. Because you see, for a E-plane, you know, 1-4 and 2-4 is opposite relation. Because if it is a E-plane nature, then definitely phase shift will be there, because this is like a E-plane. Okay, because it is like a E-plane. And once if you concentrate on the H-plane, and then S13 is equal to S23, because it is similar to H-plane. Okay, because if it is H-plane, then there is no phase difference. Okay, because if you give 10 watt power here, you will get 5 watt, here 5 watt. There will not be any power here. Or otherwise, if you give 10 watt power here, you will get 5 watt, here minus 5 watt. Here, you will not get any power. That is the idea of these notations, all these notations. And from the symmetry properties, again, port 1 and 2 is symmetric. Or if you give some power here, some power you will get here. 1 and 2 is always symmetric. So due to symmetriness, I'll write S12 is equal to S21 and S13 is equal to S31 and what else is remaining? S13 is equal to S31, then they given S24. S14, S41. Okay, so 1 and 2 we are analyzing. 1 and 2 is symmetric, and 1 and 3 is symmetric. Then S24 I have to analyze. S24 is equal to S42. S13 is equal to S31. Okay. Okay, so and S24 is equal to S42. So due to symmetriness, I can write like this. Okay. Please check it out. This is 1-4 or 2-4. Okay. I can do it later. Then what is the symmetric matrix? Generally, this is 4x4 matrix. Okay. So S11, S12, S13, S14, S21, S22, S23, S24, S31, S32, S33. S34, S41, S42, S43, S44. This is the generalized matrix. Now I know some of the properties. I had some conclusion. Based on that, I can modify this one. S11, S12, S13, S14, and again S12, S22, S13. Instead of S24, I can write minus S14 because I have this relation here. S14 can be replaced by minus S24. Okay. That's why minus S24 can be replaced by minus S14. And you know, S31 is similar to S13. So instead of S31, I can write S13. Okay. S13. And again, what is S23? S23, and again S23 is similar to S13. S23 is similar to S, because S32 is similar to S23, and again S23 is equal to S13. Okay, so I can write here S13, and again S33 is 0, because you see here S33 is 0, S44 also 0. Okay, so and again, what is S34? S34 also 0, S43 also 0. So in the table, we'll get 4 zeros. Okay, this is 0, this is 0, and this is 0. And S41 can be written as S14, and again S42 can be written as S24, but S24 can be written as minus S14. Okay, finally I get this matrix. Once then you apply the unitary properties. Now you have the matrix, you apply this condition S star is equal to I. Okay, very simple idea to apply the this operation is you take one row, then you multiply this row with this row itself, then you simply put what star mark, you simply put star mark. That's idea. Okay, you take some row, then you multiply row with that row itself with the star mark. So with that concept I will write directly, or otherwise if you are not understanding you can apply two matrix, S matrix and S star and unitary matrix. Finally you can write this equation. Once finally you are getting S11 square, S12 square, S13 square, S14 square, S12 square, S22 square, S13 square, S14 square is equal to 1, is equal to 1. Okay. And remaining equations, S11 square, S12 square is equal to 0. And S12 square plus S22 square is equal to 0. Now please concentrate on this equation. Say this is my two equations, another two equation, you concentrate here. Okay, you are adding two quantity and S11 is always positive because you have taken star operation, S into S star, finally you will get positive quantity. So some S11 value is always positive. Positive square and again positive square has to be zero. Similarly here also some positive number square has to be zero. Then what should be the value of S11? Anybody? What is the my condition? I have some number A square. I have some number, another number B square. Then that has to be zero. Then what is A? What is B? Anybody? What is the only value that will satisfy this equation? What should be the value of A and B? When I square and add two number, that has to be zero. But A and B is always positive number. A and B has to be positive number. You cannot take negative number by intuitive analysis. What is A and B? Anybody? Are you all on
zero,
the line?
Sir.
Yes, zero. Very good. So the only possible way is zero. Possible solution is zero. Because the parameters cannot be negative, that's why. Okay, with that assumption we are telling. Okay, so then again S11 is equal to 0 and similarly S12 is equal to 0 and again this S12 also 0 and this S22 also 0. So finally you are getting these values. Okay, three parameters value. Then you have